When our body sustains a wound, a number of chemical and physical processes almost immediately begin in an effort to protect our bodies. The first task is to stop any bleeding from ruptured blood vessels. Platelets, sticky cells present in our blood, will stick together and clog the ruptured vessel, thus preventing additional blood loss. Specific proteins, called fibrin, will create a mesh where the platelets have clogged the blood vessel, which forms a clot. This prevents pathogens from entering the body to cause infection or disease. Soon after, the wound will become inflamed and red. The cells at the site of the wound will release chemicals that recruit white blood cells to eliminate any pathogens that may have found their way into the body. After this initial response, the healing process begins. Special cells called fibroblasts generate collagen, the protein that makes our skin both elastic and strong. Skin cells begin to divide to replace damaged cells. Simultaneously, the clot on the wound will harden into a scab, and the skin around the scab will begin to stretch. This is when the itching starts. As you may know, every square inch of our skin is connected to nerves, providing us with our sense of touch and sensitivity to external stimuli. There are also many itch-specific nerve fibers located on our body's largest organ. These fibers tell our central nervous system that something is irritating the skin in a certain spot, in order to elicit a response from the body, such as scratching the itch. When our body sustains a wound, new cells are formed near the edges of the injury and then migrate to the center of the wound, where they connect with other cells nearby. Once this connection is made, the cells contract, effectively closing the wound. This migration of cells and the subsequent attachment to other cells causes mechanical stress in those regions, which activates itch-sensing neurons, resulting in us feeling an itch. Furthermore, during the healing process, cells release various chemical messengers to communicate with one another and create a conducive environment for healing. Many of these chemicals and the cells that produce them have been associated with itchy wounds. An itching wound means that the wound is healing well, but it can also be a warning. It might signal that an allergic reaction has been triggered, in which case the itch might save your life. However, scratching a wound is a bad idea. Scratching can interfere with the healing process. It can scrape off newly formed tissue, disturb cells in deeper layers of the skin, and cause additional damage to the surrounding healthy skin. All of this can increase the risk of infection, which leads to the wound taking longer to heal, along with eventual scarring. Though scientists have figured out a lot about itchy wounds, they're still scratching their heads about how itching works. Itching nerves make their way into the spinal cord, where most of the itch perception happens, but how the brain decodes and responds to itches is still being investigated. Generally speaking, the fact that our wounds itch when they're healing is a good sign. It means that our body's chemical and mechanical processes are working properly for a fast recovery.